This is NBC 10 News.
Local lawmakers are making a promise as a result of an NBC 10 investigation.
The point of that investigation was to end deadly hit and runs. Investigative reporter Mitch Blocker found that Philadelphia police, they don't have basic technology to track down criminal drivers and also keep track of problem spots on the roads. Now that failure may have led to deadly crashes repeating themselves.
In June 2020, a surveillance camera watched a speeding car cross Grant and Busselton Avenues and spin out of control. Sebastian Plummer was one of the five passengers.
He turned 19 in the hospital.
He had his birthday in the hospital.
Yes, the accident was on June 1st and his birthday was on June 3rd and he passed on June 6th.
Karen Bush is Sebastian's mom. She only recently discovered a deadly crash happened here before. In 2016, the same camera that watched her son's crash captured a nearly identical deadly spin out. Police say a slight rise in the intersection launched both speeding cars off Busselton Avenue, long enough for the drivers to lose control.
It's very upsetting to me that it was almost the same exact situation 4 years ago, and nothing was done about correcting the road.
Philadelphia police say they had no way of knowing about the defect before the 2020 crash. In Philly, crash investigators still measure scenes by hand and take their own still pictures. As the NBC 10 investigators first reported, at least a dozen other local departments use 3D imaging cameras capable of measuring a scene in minutes and accurate to the millimeter.
And how useful is that to the civil engineer? They can make modifications to prevent something like that from happening again.
It's also useful in a criminal investigation, according to the captain in charge of investigating crashes in Philly.
This is a good spot right here.
In October, Captain Mark Overweiss asked the company that makes this scanner for a demonstration. They used Busselton and Grant Avenues because police knew it was an example of a design flaw hand measurements and video evidence could miss. The virtual mapping highlighted the rise in the street.
Our investigation found Philadelphia crash investigators not only without scanning equipment, but also without computers, without cables, without detectives. Multiple lawmakers saw that investigation. And now they tell us they're going to fix it.
The coverage is what got our attention.
That includes Councilman Isaiah Thomas, who chairs Philadelphia's Streets and Services Committee.
You will see it as a budget priority from my team and I.
And Councilman Curtis Jones.
The crime detection equipment is right out of Fred Frenstone.
He chairs Philadelphia's Public Safety Committee.
The buck stops right here.
So what are you going to do?
So we're going to fund it.
In his budget address, Mayor Kenney committed $2 million to police technology. But if the city can't find the money...
I was disappointed and significantly shocked.
State Senator Anthony Williams told us he'd find it in Harrisburg.
Your stories and others are now giving us information about affordable technology that we should invest in.
Karen Bush knows too well what that investment could mean. She understands better than most what Philadelphia police are working with. She is a Philadelphia police officer.
There are other tools that are available to prevent this from happening in other families and other children. Then I definitely think it's something that people need to hear about.
For the investigators, I'm Mitch Blocker, NBC 10 News.